Space repetition, the resistance effect, the Pomodoro technique, mindsets to beat procrastination. These are all great tools to become more productive, but what's the point if you can't enjoy the work you do? In today's video, I'll be explaining some tricks to enjoy the work you put in. If you're ambitious or you just want to get through the school year, I highly recommend you this video as it will make it so much easier. Believe it or not, my productivity journey is started by reading one book. This one was called Nothing Is That Terrible or Nothing Is As Terrible by Rafael Santandreu, who is a Spanish author, and I highly recommend reading his books. Although I'm not sure if there's any translations. I've checked, doesn't seem like it, but that's why I'm making this video. In this book, he explains anything can be enjoyed. Anything can be blissful. So, as a part of my procrastination series, I'll be explaining how to use this power in order to enjoy your productivity journey. This is how he explains it. Imagine we would live to eat instead of eat to live or to survive. The only thing we'll be doing will be eating. We would gain so much weight, it would be so hard to survive, and life would just be extremely boring. And according to him, this is how we treat work. We live to work instead of work to live, or to survive, or to enjoy. And I have personally experienced this. I sometimes stress about the future ambitions I have, the success I might have, and the future I build inside my head instead of just enjoying the work I put in. How many of you are constantly worrying about the deadline, are worried about the next day having to go to school when you were enjoying this weekend, or having to hand in that essay? We're constantly worrying about work, and rereading this book has helped me so much, which is what inspired me to make this video. In fact, the author says he doesn't need a job to be happy, and he just does it because he enjoys it. It sounds quite simple and even cliche, but this might be the missing key to productivity. When I experienced my rut, I was only thinking about results, success, all of these things I couldn't control now, instead of just enjoying the present moment. What is the point of working for 5 years on your business when it might not even work and you just suffered the whole way through? Success isn't guaranteed, so you might as well enjoy the work you put in order to make it even easier to succeed. These are the values he uses for work. Here are some quotes from the ancient Rome to get you thinking about this mindset. The first one: remember that very little is needed to make a happy life, by Marcus Aurelius. The essence of philosophy is that man should so live that his happiness shall depend as little as possible on external things, by Epictetus. There is an effect that affects all of us, which is called the anticipatory anxiety. This is similar to the resistance effect I have talked about on some of my videos, but the difference is that it's much worse, because when we finish the activity, even though it was successful, we still feel like we didn't like it. For example, some people might go to school, finish the day, and think it was a horrible experience. And every single day, they reinforce this feeling, this anxiety, that it's gonna be bad. That's why most people hate Mondays. I think this could be fixed with the right mindset, because I have done it from experience. So I hope some of you can switch this mindset and enjoy whatever you want to enjoy. So how do we change this? Adjusting our moral system, visualize the activity as enjoyable, simplify the task or activity, and have faith that it will become better with time. Like I said before, we shouldn't worry about the results. We should just focus on making the activity enjoyable. to do with passion. Do it for the process, not the prices, and your life will become much easier. By Gary Vee. I think what he says is very accurate because success is very brief. After 5 years, 10 years, you might become successful. So what is the point of wasting all that time and suffer all that time just to get successful now, after 5-10 years? And some people might not even become successful after that much time because they didn't enjoy it. That's why most people give up. Now, this is a self-development channel, so I'm not saying don't have any goals, don't have any ambitions, don't try to become successful. What I'm saying is that you should focus on making the now enjoyable, because you shouldn't wait for any results. You shouldn't wait for the price if the price could become just working now to fully enjoy what you're doing right now. The activity itself could become the price, the goal, the motivation. I think any skill can be blissful from the point you start playing the piano, learning how to record, making a YouTube channel. I quote from the book, "When we realize that the only thing that matters is the present, love and connection with others, failure doesn't matter anymore." In cognitive psychology, visualizing is a logical way to convincing your mind that something can be joyful. For example, I would have never thought that I would like exercising. When I was younger, I used to hate football. I used to hate playing basketball. Most sports were a drag. Sure, I could play sometimes with my friends, but I would have never made it a consistent habit. And looking back, I actually did this by visualizing. One summer, my friends and I decided we wanted to get in shape. We would wake up early, go to the pull-up bars, and work out for at least 1 hour. I visualized it as fun, as something enjoyable, something I looked forward to. And looking back at it, I wish I could go back and experience it again. I have also used this technique during quarantine and it worked. After I imagined how my days would be like, I implemented them and it was so much fun. This can be applied to a school day, a workout, or a work day. The point is to convince yourself that it can be good. For example, on an afternoon, you might be working on an essay. So you can visualize yourself drinking a tea or having some good music in the background and just staying focused and curious. This process isn't automatic. It's not gonna work the next day. You need to be persistent. Convince your mind it could be good. Convince your mind again that it could be good the next day, the next day. This will be talking to your subconscious, and after some repetition, you will see results. Number 3, simplifying the activity. After we have completed the first 2 steps and you have repeated it for quite some time, like 2 weeks, 3 weeks, this process is almost automatic. Everything just becomes easier. This big idea you had becomes much easier to complete. You become much more creative because you're coming from a place of passion and enjoyment instead of fear. I saw this happen over summer. I had to program a prototype that I didn't really know about. I didn't know what a database was. I didn't know what SQL was. I barely knew how to code the site itself. So I end up procrastinating for 3 weeks or even more. I was really scared of making it. I didn't want to make it. The resistance was super high and the anticipatory anxiety was kicking in all the time. But then after I applied these rules, it just clicked. I said, I'm just going to do 3 hours every day for 2 weeks. Whatever happens, I'm just going to do those 3 hours and hope it goes well. And indeed, it did go well. I enjoyed it so much. I actually wanted to do more than 4 hours and I ended up with a quite good prototype, which I still need to work on. Number 4, have faith it will get better over time. This is obviously a pretty big change to the way we think. We always see work as something negative and we're always looking forward to our breaks, staying on our phone, watching a TV show. So every time our mind goes into worry mode, into this anxiety I talked about, just remember you need to step back and apply everything I said on this video. We sometimes forget true success doesn't come from working super hard or having a big talent or demanding so much from yourself. True success comes from curiosity. it becomes simple. It's almost natural. For example, the writer Ernest Hemingway will limit the hours he will write for to create better writings. He said this was his key to success, to making really good writings, because he would always have passion for writing because it was so easy, so natural. So I hope this video has helped you as much as this information has helped me. It completely changed the way I see productivity now. I look forward to everything, making these videos, going to school, anything. So always feel free to comment down below if you disagree with me, if you'd like to ask any questions, I will reply to all the comments. See you on the next one.